Today we'll start the alkenes. As last class we have defined, they are nothing but the hydrocarbons, specific compounds with unsaturated aliphatic hydrocarbons with carbon-carbon double bond as a functional group, right? There are 4 points we are covering. One is they are unsaturated, means containing some pi bonds. Aliphatic means open chain compounds, no cyclic. Hydrocarbons with only made up of with the hydrogen and the carbons. And having specifically double bonds are alkenes. If in this place, if a triple bond is there, the definition goes to the alkynes, right? So, we have a model example for this compound is a chapter is ethylene. However, the preparations and all that we will take with reference to this one, but wherever it is necessary, we will take the other examples also. So, first let us take some preparations of this compound. The double bond can be constructed by the two methods. One is by taking the triple bond, you can prepare the double bond. This is first method. Another method is you can also prepare a compound containing some AB groups. Dropping this AB, also you can prepare the double bond. These are the two fundamental methods. Now, let us go for the first method. In this first method, the triple bonded compound, if you add some hydrogens, the care must be taken. Otherwise, it will give the, first it will become double bond, then it will become single bond also. So, that is a specific type of reagents like we have a method called a catalyst called Lindlar's catalyst. This catalyst will stop the reduction at one stage. So, here it is what is this Lindlar's catalyst means? A palladium supported by the barium sulfate in quinoline solvent. So, the actual reagent is hydrogen. So, the hydrogen we are adding to the acetylene. In presence of this specific condition, we are getting the ethylene. However, the same reaction you too can also get from adding the liquid ammonia and sodium metal also. But we have a specific example, like for example, if a triple bond compound containing two methyls this side, that side. This is nothing but the two methyls containing acetylene. You can call dimethyl acetylene or tubutine. In this tubutine, if Lindlar's catalyst and the hydrogen is used, this is the first method is used, you are going to get the two hydrogens added from the one-sided. So, what you are getting? A cis compound or Z type of the alkene you are getting. Whereas, if the same compound, if it is treated with this liquid ammonia and sodium, second method if you adopt, the two hydrogens added will be on the opposite side, right? If you go to the details, why it is so happening means, the first one, the hydrogen and acetylene is adsorbed on the palladium, hydrogen comes from one side, therefore, cis type of the product. Hydrogen comes from one side means the other two methyls shift to the same side. Or in the other method, when ammonia is added to the sodium, sodium liberates electrons. That electrons will be added and you will get acetylene will become into the electronated, one electron will become two electrons, and these two electrons will have some repulsion. So, therefore, the alkyl groups will be rearranged. The alkyl group one cloud goes to the other side due to the repulsion. So, therefore, the clouds will take up the other sides. Opposite side, so that the methyl groups also occupy in the opposite side. Later on, protons will be added. So it is a sort of the electronation followed by the protonation.
Electrons are given by the sodium and protons are given by the NH3. This will become NH2, Na plus and NH2 forms NaNH2. That is a side product. So in installment wise, first electrons are added, followed by the protons are added to give the trans type, that is a E type of the compound. Trans compounds, in this particular case, naturally it happens to be a E, because number one groups according to the CIP, number one groups are opposite, therefore N-tagagan. If the number one groups are same side with reference to the double bond, it is Zeus-M and Z type of the compound, right? So this is the one of the method which is used for the preparation of the controlled reduction method.
Now let us take the second methods. In the second methods, we have taking the single bond, getting the double bonds, okay? Right. For this second method, you can drop the two halogens. This is called dehalogenation. Two halogens can be dropped. However, the halogens should be side by side. X can be a chloro, bromo or iodo, but if iodines are there, automatically they eliminate. So therefore, chloride or bromide, 1,2-dichloro is called vicinal dihalides. On treatment with the zinc and just boil for that zinc dust, two halogens will be removed, you will get a double bond. This is one method. And minus of 1H and 1X, this is called what? Removal is we are expressing with the D. Dehydrohalogenation is nothing but the removal of the 1H, one halogen, for which the compound should have one halogen at least, side carbon, if hydrogen is there, they will be removed. What is the molecule we are removing? A HX. This is nothing but an acid in terms of the HCl, hydrochloric acid. So to remove the acid, you can guess the reagent. Acid is removed, so therefore alcoholic KOH, and heat for some time, this KOH reacts and you will get this type of the alkene formation is possible, right? This is the second method. Similarly, there are two more methods are there for the preparation of the double bond. Removal of HOH. HOH means nothing but the water removal, is known as dehydration. Dehydration is taking place when a compound contains a OH group. So OH and side carbon H. So this is a beta elimination, H and OH from the side by side carbons we are removing. H and OH from the same carbon cannot be removed. Side by side beta elimination leads to give the double bond. So removal of water is catalyzed by the concentrated H2SO4 at around 350 degrees centigrade. Beyond 170 is okay. More than 170 degrees centigrade, dehydration takes place, you will get the double bond formation. You do have one more method in for the this type of the double bond formation, that is a minus of CO2 groups from the side by side, minus of CO2. Two groups will be removed. So one COOH and another COOH if you remove. If there is no bond, that is a sodium salts if you take, there is no bond if water is added and electrolyzed. What is this method? Kolbe electrolysis method. In this method, CO2 minus will become first CO minus dot, and it breaks into dot will be joined, you will get the CC bond formation. In fact, sodium acetate will give the ethane. But already if a bond is there, then it will become a 4-carbon dioic acid known as succinic acid. Succinic acid and Kolbe electrolysis will make a double bond. Already bond is there, double bond comes. If already double bond is there, this molecule happens to be a maleic acid, 2COH same side. You can take opposite one, fumaric acid also, even that also will. Because anyhow the opposite groups we are removing. So the double bond will become triple bond. This is the method used for that. Therefore, disodium maleate, same side, or disodium opposite side, that is fumarate,
also will give the same, the triple bond. You two can have some groups also here, so that substituted alkynes also can be prepared. So all these four methods are nothing but the elimination techniques. And the second method, as I said, AB groups can be dropped so that double bond is prepared. Some of these methods, as I said, can be extended for the alkynes also. This we take in the alkynes. Now let us go for the sum of the properties. The properties can be broadly can be said as the first property is nothing but the electrophilic addition reaction. Second property will be the oxidation. Third property will be the polymerization. For an alkene, if it is an alkene containing this type of hydrogen, that is called what? The double bond attached carbon is holds hydrogen is called vinylic. Next carbon hydrogen is called allylic. So this type of hydrogen, if it is there, another special property called allylic substitution also will be the one of the special property. But let us go to the electrophilic addition reaction. Alkenes, when you treat it with the HX type of the reagent, H plus X minus. X can be a halogen, X can be a OH, or X can be some other groups like sulfuric acid, sulfate anion also. In all these cases, both will be trying to attack on this compound, but the alkene is an electron rich molecule. Because of the loose bond of the pi bond, there is no minus charge, but the way of the bond formed is a weak bond. So therefore, electron rich molecule, we'll say. So whenever X minus 1 to attack, there is a repulsion. But if H plus 1 to come, there is an attraction. So as the H plus comes, the bond polarizes slowly, H attacks. So step 1 leads to give the one H attacking on the intermediate species C plus is formed, on which X minus is added. So therefore, one side X, one side H is added, passing through carbocation as an intermediate. It's a two-step reaction. In the first step, electrophile is added. Therefore, we are calling it a electrophilic addition. What are the examples? So you can take HCl, HBr, HI, and so on. You can take HOH, you can take sulfuric acid, HOCl also you can take, HOCl, hypochlorous acid. So the first attacking species in the case of HCl is H plus. In the case of water, actually, the H plus should be the one, but it is catalyzed by the concentrated sulfuric acid. Therefore, what is the attacking species means? Sulfuric acid H plus is the attacking species. Isn't it? Only sulfuric acid concentrated at room temperature, if you add, H plus will be the attacking species. In the HOCl, Cl plus is the attacking species. HOCl can break up into H plus OCl minus, but Cl plus and H plus, Cl plus is the stronger electrophile. Therefore, first Cl plus attacks, then a carbocation, and followed by then OH minus will be attacking, isn't it? So all these reagents will give this type of the addition reactions passing through this one, including the reagents like X2. When X2, if you take, one will be the X plus will be there, X minus will be there. First X plus will be added, followed by the X minus, for which you can take best examples chlorine and the bromine. Bromine generally will be taken in the CCl4 liquid because of the evaporation and the dangerous to handling and all that. It is chosen always a suitable solvent which will not participate in the addition reaction. Chlorine directly gas you can add it. Now bromine, when you add bromine plus will be the attacking species, carbocation on that Br minus. In the case of bromine, we have one noticeable point. Bromine is a red color liquid. When you add that liquid to the alkene, soon the red color disappear because the consumption of the bromine reagent. We can identify the reaction progress or the identify the alkene presence by adding this bromine CCl4. And the next is the oxidation reaction. In the oxidation reaction, we have one reagent called alkaline KMnO4. KMnO4 is an oxidizing agent, but in alkaline medium is a weak oxidizing agent. Slowly, MnO4 whole molecule will attack because of the water. It decomposes and gives two OHs. These two OHs happens to be same side because MnO4 attacks from the one-sidedly. So, two OHs, that the product 1,2 diols are called specifically glycols. If ethylene is taken, the product is called ethylene glycol and so on. Instead, if permanganate is added with some water, the acidic medium. This is called acidified KMnO4. For generally for the alkaline medium, either KOH or K2CO3 is used. For the acidification, sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid is used. This is little faster oxidation. So therefore, even the breakage takes place. In the case of a compound like a 2-butene is there, it breaks into 2 moles of acetic acid. In the case of ethylene, it will break up into the formic acid. But the bigger the molecule, we know the different products. If a compound is like this, the one side acid is formed, that is one alkyl group containing side is acid, two alkyl side is ketone is formed in this. That is acidified permanganate will give the one side where two alkyls are there will give the ketone. Only one alkyl containing is becomes acid. So COOH is carboxylic acids are formed when single is substituted. In this case, two acetic acid. In this case, acetic acid and acid. If one more alkyl is there, both the sides you will get the ketones. So this is acidified permanganate oxidation, and the oxidation with the ozone also you can take. Ozone will make an ozonide like this. First of all, you will get a O3 molecule added, and then it undergoes a rearrangement so that two oxygens one side, one oxygen another side. This breaks up, finally it will become into two pieces. In the case of ethylene, you will get the 2 moles of formaldehyde. 2 moles of formaldehyde is formed. But in the case of the bigger the compound, like for example, this compound, if you treat it with the ozonolysis, the ozonide formed, you can hydrolyze with the two different types. One is adding the water in presence of the zinc or any reducing agent. This is called reductive ozonolysis. As such, will give the one side ketone and one side aldehyde is formed. In the case of after getting the ozonide, only water if you add, only water. That means this compound will give these two when added O3 followed by only water. No more zinc. This is called oxidative ozonolysis. Once again, this is equals to the acidified permanganate, and oxidative ozonolysis will give the same answer. Okay, right. This is the oxidation methodology. And the polymerization, ethylene polymerizes to give the polyethylene. Any polymerizing, that is a radically or acidified methods are there. Little high pressure in the acid medium will encourage this reaction. You will get a huge number of alkenes will be joined. You will get a polyethylene. Polyethylene. However, in the market we have a huge number of polymers like ethylene containing chlorine. You will get a polyvinyl chloride, a PVC plastic, a vinyl with containing a cyanide. You get a polyacrylonitrile. Okay, and the vinyl with phenyl group, this is called styrene. You will get a polystyrene, and so on, depending upon the different substitutions, we are going to get the different varieties of the polymers. Lastly, we take this type of the compound, that is when alkenes attached with an alkyl group holding one hydrogen, this is called allylic substitution. In the allylic substitution, if the chlorine is added, normal case two chlorines will be added. But this reaction is at 500 degrees or little more than the 500 degrees. The allylic hydrogen happens to be substituted. This is called allylic substitution. This is an example for the free radical substitution reaction. This is not an addition. Normally, if chlorine is added, it undergoes electrophilic addition, first Cl plus followed by the Cl minus. But in the rare case, high temperature breaks the chlorines into dot, and the dot making the dot on the allylic carbon get resonance stabilized. Therefore, the allylic substitution is the reason. Now, we will see some questions from the last few years, followed by some questions, acceptable questions expected for the next year we can follow. See here, 1 mole of alkene X on ozonolysis gave 1 mole of acetaldehyde and 1 mole of acetone. See here, the case just now we have discussed this one. An alkene containing the structure is going to give the 1 acetone molecule as well as 1 acetaldehyde molecule, right? Now, the getting back the compound is, just remove this, you will get the structure of the alkene. Nothing but it is a 2-methyl-2-butene, so therefore answer is 1. Answer is 1. Next. identify B in the following reaction. Ethylene treated with the HCl, HCl is added, you will get the ethyl chloride. That ethyl chloride is reduced with the 2 moles of hydrogen using the zinc copper, and that you will get ethane. That is, in the ethane chapter we have seen ethyl chloride reduces to ethane. So the answer is the 2, that is the ethane is the formation. So first of all, you see that HCl addition makes a ethyl chloride, isn't it? Right. Next. Which of the following reagents when heated with ethyl chloride forms ethylene? So ethyl chloride to ethylene, he is asking. Ethyl chloride to ethylene. That means you are going to remove the H from here, Cl from here. HCl, as I said, HCl means acid. Acid should be removed. So guess, acid should be removed means a base should be used. That is alcoholic KOH. If aqueous KOH is used, what happens? If aqueous KOH is used, it will become a substitution reaction because of the OH is a stronger base replaces. In alcoholic KOH, as the strength is strong, HCl acid is removed, alkene is taking place. That is an elimination. This is a substitution reaction, totally different. Next. Which of the following compounds does not form an ozonide? In fact, alkynes also forms ozonides. So, ene and ine should not be there. So, therefore, answer is clearly ene, that is the fourth propane. Next. The compound formed when tubutene is treated with acidified KMnO4. Tubutene, just now we have seen acidified KMnO4 converts the alkenes into pieces. That too, if a substitutions are not there, you will get acetic acid. That means 2 moles of acetic acid is formed. If a substitution is there, the pieces will become a acetone and acetic acid, isn't it? So that is what he is asking. So he is getting a when butene is treated with acidified KM 2 methyl, when 2-butene, simple one, 2-butene is treated, you will get alone acetic acid. That is answer 2. Next. Bayer's reagent is nothing but an alkaline KMnO4. Here there is a name for that, so on the, based on the scientist's name. So it is a Bayer's reagent, means alkaline KMnO4, or neutral, not having any acidic medium, neutral cold dilute KMnO4 is known as Bayer's reagent, which will mildly oxidize to give the glycol. Ethylene glycol is formed. So from ethylene you get this glycol. Next. So answer is 3. Which of the following is not suitable for the better preparation of alkenes? As we have seen, different methods are there for the elimination techniques. Dehalogenation is possible, dehydration is possible, dehydrohalogenation is possible. Dehydrogenation means removal of the hydrogens. Like for example, ethane, if you take, removal of this hydrogen is not that fair. You can do it using some catalyst, but this is not a suitable method for the preparation of the alkenes. So answer goes to the 4. Next. Dehydration of alcohols to give alkenes is catalyzed by the dehydration, means removal of water. Sulfuric acid has a vision affection towards the water. So therefore, concentrated sulfuric acid at room temperature slightly increased at beyond 170 degrees, you will get this dehydration reaction. Reagent is 2. Therefore, answer 2. Next. Kolbe electrolysis can be applied for the preparation of, as I said, if there is no bond, bond is formed alkanes. If there is a bond, alkenes are coming. If already 2 bonds are there, alkynes will come. So all the 1, 2, 3 is right. Therefore, 4th answer is right. Next. Ethylene plus HOCl. In the HOCl, as I said, HOCl can break up into H plus OCl minus also. This happens to be when sodium hydroxide is added, in fact. But in this reaction, HOCl breaks up into Cl plus, which is a more powerful electrophile than so-called breaking H plus. Now the Cl plus attacks as a step 1, then you will get the carbocation on which OH minus adds a chlorohydrin is formed. That is the Cl plus. That answer 2 is right. Next. What is the major product formed when 1-butene is treated with the HBr catalyzed by the hydrogen peroxide? That's what here 1-butene as the 2-butene, what is asked? 1-butene. 1-butene, if you add HBr, a lone HBr, what happens, you see? As I said, what happens? First H plus will be added, followed by the Br minus. This is the H plus. So you will add, you will get the H plus on the terminal, so that 2-degree carbocation is formed, followed by the Br minus attacks. So therefore, the what is the answer? 2-bromo. Even if H adds here, you will get 1-bromo as a minor product. But in this case, 2-bromo will be the major. But when HBr is added in presence of hydrogen peroxide, this makes a lot of difference here. It is not necessary hydrogen peroxide. Any other peroxide also you can use, get the same result. All these peroxides, first they break up into the OH dots. This OH dot will react with the Br, HBr, and takes the H dot and forms into H2O, liberating the Br dot. Now, what is the first attacking species? Therefore, Br dot will be the attacking. Where this Br dot should be added? It will be added on the terminal once again to get the 2-degree free radical, which is more stable than the 1-degree according to the inductive effect or hyperconjugation. 2-degree free radicals are more stable. So now the already Br is added, H dot is due, but where is this H dot? Means H dot is not free in the form of water. The water breaks up into the H dot and the OH dot. This H dot is consumed here, so that the one, that is bromo propane, is formed. 1-bromo butane is formed as a major product. See the now the difference. Only HBr, if it is added, 2-bromo will be the major. And mixture you will get definitely, but 2-bromo will be the major. When HBr alone, no other reagent is induced by this peroxide effect, HBr is suitable. When HCl is added, it's already break up into the plus minus, so reagents cannot induce. Only HBr in presence of hydrogen peroxide or any other peroxide, it is induced through the free radical addition mechanism. So HBr addition to alkenes is electrophilic addition. HBr addition in presence of peroxides is free radical addition, passing through the more stable intermediate 2-degree. Here also 2-degree passing through more stable, but H goes to the terminal, Br comes to middle. Here the bromine goes to the terminal, H comes to middle. So therefore 1-bromo will be the major product in this. So answer is therefore 4, 1-bromo compound. Next, which of the following alkene gives a only acetaldehyde product in ozonolysis? Ordinary ozonolysis, always you remember, it is a reductive ozonolysis. That means adding ozone followed by the hydrolysis using the zinc or the dimethyl sulfur or nascent hydrogen, something like that, always reducing agent will be there. That is a ordinary ozonolysis, means reductive. So safely you can answer that only acetaldehyde, means it should be 2-butene. 2-butene is, that is answer 3, therefore. Both the sides acetaldehyde is coming. Next, which of the following reagents are decolorized when treated with the alkene? As I said, bromine CCl4 is decolorized because it is red color. Alkaline KMnO4 is also dark violetish, the pink color will be there. So the moment I add one drop of the permanganate, MnO4 is converted to MnO2, which is in aqueous medium almost colorless. So therefore, it is said to be a alkaline KMnO4, also decolorizes. It can be used as a test for the differentiate between the alkanes and alkenes. So therefore, both 2 and 3 will be the answers. Answer 4 is right. Therefore, next. PVC is a polymer prepared by the polymerization of, just now we have seen, polyvinyl chloride. PVC stands for polyvinyl chloride. So vinyl chloride will give the polyvinyl chloride. Next. Diels-Alder reaction will not take place with which of the following reagents? This actually, this the Diels-Alder reaction, the purview will be slightly above than this alkene chapter. There are some alkenes which are called one double bond. If it is attached with another double bond, they are called cumulated alkenes. If the double bond is separated by one single bond, they are called conjugated. Conjugated, isn't it? Conjugated. This is called cumulated. Cumulated, conjugated. The double bonds, if they are separated by n number of CH2 units, n cannot be 0. N can be 1, 2, 3, 4. These are called isolated. there are three types of the diens. This isolated diens properties will be in into twice, that's all. There is no specific property. Cumulated or unstable, they rearrange, they undergo double tautomerization gives to the alkynes. In fact, magnesium carbide and hydrolysis will give the first allene. CH2 is known as allene. Allene tautomerizes to give the alkyne. Therefore, there is no existence for these compounds. Only the important is conjugated dienes. Now, these conjugated dienes have got the three or four important properties. One is a resonance stability. As we have seen, double bonds are in alternatively. So, therefore, they undergo very good stabilization. We have a natural occurrence and so on to methyl butadiene. This unpolymerization gives the natural rubber and so on. We have a lot of importance because of the resonance stability. The next property is they undergo 1,4 addition. It is slightly little beyond the alkene, but still then one question is there. When bromine is added, if excess is added, 1,2,3,4 tetrabromo butane is formed. But if only one mole is added, major product will be, remember, 1,4 dibromo compound. This is the major product. Minor product is one double bond restored, 1,2 set of bromine will be added. Major product is 1,4 dibromotubutene is formed. This is called 1,4 addition. Another one is this Diels-Alder reaction. In the Diels-Alder reaction, a butadiene is added with another alkene. This double bond comes here, this comes here, this comes here, R11 electron you can show. This is totally a pericyclic reaction, but somehow the reaction is getting a cyclohexene is coming. This is called a Diels-Alder reaction, a great potential reaction, has got a lot of importance in the higher chemistry. However, we are dealing with this reaction for which what is necessary? A conjugation of double bond is needed. So, in the first example itself, the two double bonds are isolated. See, through one CH2. Therefore, one is not eligible, second is eligible, third is eligible, fourth is eligible. And the other side alkene can have some withdrawing or donating groups. That's not the matter. You can have some groups, but the double bond should be alternatively present. Therefore, answer one is the correct answer. Next. I think this makes an alkene topic. Let's go to the next topic, that is alkynes. Alkyne is very much similar with the alkene. So, they are also defined similarly. Unsaturated aliphatic hydrocarbons containing the triple bonds. If the triple bonds are there in the compound as a functional group, however, the other functional group, if it is there, which is more reactive, now the compound name will be different. But as long as this triple bond is responsible for the reagents, they are called alkynes. In the alkynes, the first member happens to be a very popular compound known as commonly acetylene. Systematically, it is called ethyne. So, root word, functional group, that is the saturation, and then the functional group E. But it is also known as acetylene commonly. So, therefore, all if one alkyl group is there, I call alkyl acetylene and so on. So, entire compounds chapter is known as what? Alkyl acetylenes, dialkyl acetylenes, so acetylenic chapter. The chapter is called acetylenic chapter. Now, let us go to the preparation of this acetylene. Triple bond can be prepared from the elimination techniques. As we have a sort of repetition, that's why alkenes and alkynes together we are seeing. Or many elimination methods like X2 elimination. What is this? Dehalogenation. Now, if you see, we have seen, if two halogens subsequently successfully, if you remove it, you are going to get a double bond, right? If one more set of X and X, what is the name? 1,1,2,2 tetrahalo compounds like tetrachloro, tetrabromo compounds, twice zinc is used, 2 moles of zinc is consumed, you are going to get the triple bond, right? So, dehalogenation workout, this is the one of the simple example. Now, similarly, minus of HX, dehydrohalogenation. So, one H and one X if you remove, you are going to get the double bond. Now, if you want to remove the two sets of this is minus of HX, catalyzed by the alcoholic KOH, isn't it? The same reagent, you can use one H and the X. But the first removal is easy. The second removal, once HX is removed, X containing alkenes are resonance stabilized. Therefore, you need little more stronger base. The second step, either heating or the strength of the alkali should be increased, or we have a suitable reagent called sodamide. Instead of alkaline, that is alcoholic KOH, you can use sodamide so that two eliminations can be simultaneously can be removed and you may get a triple bond. And the third one is removal of CO2. That is a called by electrolysis. If already double bond is there and 2 moles of COO minus and COO minus with the metals like sodium or potassium, if it is there, and 2 moles will be removed, you will get the triple bond formation. Isn't it? So all this dehalogenation, dehydrohalogenation, decarboxylation can be successfully, just like in the alkene case, as it is, you can take into this chapter also extend. But we have some commercial methods are there for the preparation of alkynes. What is that commercial method? One method is you take calcium carbonate, which is abundantly available in different places. This is called limestone. This limestone heated strongly around 1000 degrees centigrade, you will liberation of CO2 you find. But in the kiln you find the calcium oxide. This is called a quicklime. Quicklime we find in the villages, big kilns will be there. So in that quicklime is formed. This you heat it with the coal. Coal is nothing but the carbon, however sometimes some compounds you may find. But this carbon you add it and heat it once again, the calcium oxide reacts with the carbon and some of the carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide will be expelled. And the calcium is converted to calcium carbide. This is known as calcium carbide. This calcium carbide on hydrolysis, just add water, you need not to take anything, just add water, calcium carbide will have a structure like this, a triple bond will be already existing, calcium is a +2, therefore ionic bonds are there. So if you add water, H and OH will be breaking this carbide, ionic carbide becomes into the acetylene. Okay, a triple bond with a hydrogen and hydrogen. This happens to be a gas, therefore it comes out quickly. There is no botheration of separation, purification and all that. So the pure acetylene gas will be prepared. So therefore this is commercially and industrially very much useful. From the starting materials are nothing but the limestone and the coal and the water. These are three are very cheap material. Therefore on a large scale, the acetylene can be prepared at a lower cost starting from this calcium carbide. Finally, what we are doing is the hydrolysis of calcium carbide. Where from calcium carbide? From the quicklime, from the limestone. So therefore, it is a linked reaction. However, the method is called hydrolysis of calcium carbide. Now, let us see some of the properties of this. Just I will explain, then go to the questions. How acetylene respond to the different reagents. This also undergoes the reactions like electrophilic addition reactions, but it is double. Why double means the two pi bonds are there, therefore it undergoes twice the electrophilic addition reactions. Addition with the X2 you can find, addition with the HOX you can find, addition with HX you can find, addition with water, addition with sulfuric acid and so on. Several reagents will add on the across the triple bond. Okay, then you have some oxidation with alkaline KMnO4 or acidified KMnO4, ozone. KMnO4 with the acidified ozonolysis reactions with the reductive and the oxidative, and then polymerization also you can find as a special reaction. Acidity you can find. This will be the special case of the acetylene. Acetylene shows acidic property. We will see the reason and all that. First, let us take some of the reactions of this electrophilic addition. Acetylene reacts with the 2 moles of HCl. First mole when you add, you will get vinyl chloride. Second mole when you are adding, which side Cl, which side H is a problem here? It follows Markovnikov rule, because the H plus, if it is added this side or that side, if H is added here, carbocation here, if H is added, let us see that option. If H is added, you will get a carbocation here, right, which is attached with a chlorine having a lone pair shows resonance stability. Therefore, H will be added here, a stable carbocation, then Cl is added. Therefore, finally, what comes is 1,1-dichloroacetylene will be formed. That means they are following second step, following you can say a raw rule, that is a Markovnikov rule can be implemented here, and so that the Cl is added to the Cl side, or the X minus is added where hydrogens are less can be implemented. Then you add the reagents like HOX again, twice the reaction, X2 also, XX and XX. But the interesting reaction is H2O. H2O addition alone, H2O, even in the case of ethylene, it is not possible. Sulfuric acid and water can be used. Here also, concentrated sulfuric acid should be used as a one reagent. Here, the mercuric sulfate is the another reagent is used. It shows usage of the two reagents shows acetylene is less reactive than the ethylene. So when two reagents are there, what happens? One H and OH is added. This compound happens to be a vinyl alcohol, tautomerizes to give the acetaldehyde. In the acetaldehyde, the double bond goes that side, hydrogen comes this side, or it tautomerizes, in fact, give the acetaldehyde. The case may be expanded, that is extended to the propyne. In the propyne, the set, that is first addition itself, OH goes to the middle. So the ol is formed in the center, following the Markovnikov rule. Now the tautomerism will give the acetone. Right? So therefore, you can ask a question that whatever the Y group, let us say, a Y attached acetylene will give the Y attached COCH3. If a benzene is there, acetophenone is formed, and so on. You can extend this reaction to the higher chemistry also. So now this is the one important reaction. Hydration of the alkynes are going to give some aldehydes and ketones. Alone acetylene, if you take acetaldehyde, propyne is taken, acetone is the reason. Okay, so in the sulfuric acid also will be added at low room temperature added. If you heat it, it gives back. And alkaline KMnO4 is also not much important, but the acetylene oxidizes in acidified KMnO4 into oxalic acid. If the oxidizing agent is a little further oxidation, which leads to give the carbon dioxide and water, no doubt. Further oxidation. But several times the alkaline KMnO4, that is Bayer's reagent, if you add, oxalic acid is the reagent. If reductive ozonolysis, ozone followed by the zinc, in hydrolysis when you use zinc, you will get the triple bond. Out of the triple bond, double bond will be cut. You will get CHO and the CHO. That is glyoxal will be the answer. So remember, reductive ozonolysis will give the glyoxal, but the Bayer's reagent or boiling further oxidation gives the carbon dioxide. Mild oxidation will give the oxalic acid. Oxalic acid. Okay? Then a polymerization. Polymerization I will give once again. Polymerization of acetylene has one important point. Alkenes polymerize, real polymerization, that is poly means many. MERS means molecule, many molecules will join, you will get a giant molecule. But in this case, you don't find. Must be the reason is it is less reactive than the ethylene. So the first is it is a dimerization when copper chloride, Cu2Cl2, in presence of ammonium chloride. If ammonium hydroxide is used, you will get a silver derivatives formation that is used in the hydroxy, that acidity will be neutralized. This is an acidic medium, it will become a acetylene added to ethylene. This is called vinyl acetylene. Vinyl acetylene, we have some industrial applications. If you reduce it, you will get a butadiene and buna rubber and so on will be generated. Here, the dimerization with the nickel cyanide. Nickel cyanide, if you add, 4 molecules will be added, you will get the 4 acetylenes are joined. This is dimerization, this is tetramerization. If 3 molecules means trimerization. Trimerization can and cyclization leads to give the benzene. Benzene is aromatic, whereas this is a non-aromatic compound. The trimerization is taking place when red hot copper tubes when you use, you are getting this type of the benzene formation. Three, all these are not exactly polymerization, because poly means many, where is the many, only few. A few polymerization, little low level polymerization is taking place. In the case of if methyl containing acetylene, you may get a benzene containing three methyls, which is known as a mesityline. Mesityline is an extension to the polymerization of acetylene gives benzene, methyl extra, so therefore three methyls comes, it is called 1,3,5 trimethyl benzene known as mesityline, right? And acetylene has another property, what is that? Acidic property. This acidic property also, I will just focus one or two points. Why, how come this acidity for the acetylene? Acetylene, if a single bond is there, actually they are neutral. The CC bond and CH bonds are non-polar, therefore the compound is absolutely neutral. There is no acidic or basic quality. When a double bond is there, but the pi bond is excess, therefore electron rich means basic nature, right? But whereas a triple bond is there, what happens here? A triple bonded carbon is a sp hybridized. As the s character is 50%, the electrons will be pulled from the both the sides. The hydrogen electrons are pulled too much, so that uneven breakage leads to give the c minus and h plus formation. Means what? A proton donor is nothing but the acid. So the sp hybridized carbon, whenever attached with hydrogen, shows acidic nature, not because of the triple bond. In fact, that's why a triple bond attached to both the sides carbons is no more acidic, whereas a triple bond attached with a hydrogen, that is 1-butyne. What exactly difference between 1-butyne, 2-butyne? In 1-butyne there is no hydrogen attached to sp carbon. In one butane, there is a hydrogen attached to sp carbon. Therefore, this hydrogen comes out as a H plus, because the carbon pulls. Here, the hydrogens are attached to the sp3 carbons. Therefore, neutral. So, 2-butane is a neutral. Moreover, it is slightly basic also because of the presence of the electrons. But 1-butane is acidic. Whenever acidic, we are going to have some specific reactions. Because of this acidic nature, a triple bonded hydrogen can react with a sodium metal, making a sodium salts and liberating the hydrogen gas. This is the one of the example for the acidity. There are two more reactions. One is silver nitrate. When silver nitrate is added in presence of the ammonium hydroxide, ammonical silver nitrate, called what? Tollens reagent. This gives a silver salt. Both the sides silver comes, and it so happened the silver salts are white color precipitates there. Therefore, you can easily identify whether the given compound is acetylene or not. So, if this add Tollens reagent, if you get white precipitate, say it is acetylene. Ethane and ethylene will not give this reactions. Similarly, there is one more reagent, cuprous chloride in presence of ammonium hydroxide. Previously, we have seen here cuprous chloride, ammonium chloride is a dimerizing reagent, but cuprous chloride in presence of basic medium, it is undergoing the neutralization. Basic medium, neutralization. Acidic medium, polymerization. In basic medium, you are getting H plus are neutralized with OH minus. In this place, coppers are coming, dicopper acetylide is coming. It so happened once again, it is a red color precipitate. So the reaction gives precipitates. You can use it for the quantitative estimations, and also the colors are there. Therefore, quantitative estimation come qualitative estimation, both can be applied in this to both the reactions. So, but the point, remember, the hydrogen should be attached to the sp carbon. So 2-butyne, 1-butyne, only 1-butyne gives coloration, not the 2-butyne. Okay, this is the gist of this one. Let us see some questions on the alkynes chapter and try to answer. Identify the alkyne in the following sequence of reactions. So the alkyne is reduced with the Lindlar's catalyst, you will get an alkene. The alkene on OH analysis gives a carbonyl compound, maybe an aldehyde or a ketone. Isn't it? The same compound is formed in the Wacker's process of alkene. So the alkene is a special oxidation to give the acetaldehyde. So the B is acetaldehyde. B is acetaldehyde means A must be 2-butene. 2-butene is formed from alkyne means A. So therefore, the A must be the 2-butene. B must be the acetaldehyde. So therefore, the question what is here? Identify the alkyne. What alkyne is it? 2-butyne must be the A. So therefore, answer 1 is the right answer. Alkyne must be 1-butyne, 2-butyne. Tubutane gives tubutin, tubutin gives acetaldehyde. The same acetaldehyde is formed in the Weyl-Krupp oxidation of the alkene. Next, what are X, Y respectively in the following reaction? The X and Y are the first one is the tubutine on Linalool's catalyst, Z product is formed, whereas the other side is trans product is formed. Therefore, X and first X is asked, E product means that is answer one, sodium liquid ammonia is the trans compound formation and the Linalool's catalyst is cis compound. Next, aqueous solution of an organic compound A on electrolysis liberates acetylene and carbon dioxide at anode. So, the compound should have a double bond, that is maleate, it should be the answer, potassium or sodium maleate, answer 4 is the right answer. Next, the following reaction is an example for. So, if the two bromines are going out, no doubt, but two hydrogens also going out. See, it's a acetylene is formed, dehydrohalogenation. So, dehydrobromination is the answer 2, therefore. Next, when acetylene is passed through the red hot, benzene is formed. So, when which of the following reactions will yield X as a major product? So, a benzene. Which one of the following is, the benzene is another method he is asking. The benzene preparation question comes to actually benzene preparation. Next topic it goes actually. Phenol on reduction with zinc you will get benzene. Next, the reagent used for converting acetylene to oxalic acid is the KMnO4 oxidation method 3. Next, which one of the following reagents with ammonical cuprous chloride red precipitate comes, that is acetylene should be the answer 2, therefore. Next, the number of acetylene molecule required to form 1 mole of benzene, as I said trimerization leads to benzene, 3 molecules, answer 3. Next, a gas decolorizes bromine CCl4 and forms a precipitate with ammonical silver nitrate. Ethylene also decolorizes, but it won't give the red color, the white color with the ammonical silver nitrate. So, the answer must be acetylene 1. Next, the homology of ethyne. Homology means the same type of the molecular formula extended for the next compound. The difference should be CH2 unit. Molecular weight difference should be 14 units. The same representing formula and so on. So, homology means propyne is the answer. Next, the number of pi bonds in the product formed in passing acetylene is benzene is formed, therefore, pi bonds in the product formed by passing acetylene through dilute sulfuric acid. So, it is a hydration which gives a vinyl alcohol followed by tautomerizes to acetaldehyde. In acetaldehyde, one pi bond is there, therefore, answer goes to 2. Right. Next, which one of the following compounds is most acidic? In fact, here acetylene should be the answer, but it's one point you remember, acetylene is acidic. Acidic means we think it should not touch it. In fact, acetylene is less acidic than even water. So, therefore, the question here, it is the answer is alcohol is given here. So, the sodium acetylide when treated with alcohol, it replaces the sodium salt, in fact. Therefore, the alcohols and waters are called more stronger acids than acetylene. So, the answer goes to the 2, therefore. Next, in the following reaction sequence, the copper calcium carbide gives acetylene. Acetylene on hot iron tubes gives the benzene, and benzene toluene is the answer, final answer. So, R is toluene, answer goes to the 2, therefore. Methylation of benzene gives toluene. Next, among the following, the hydrocarbon which decolorizes bromine water but does not give precipitate with ammonical silver nitrate means it must be ethylene. So, ethylene means answer goes to the C2H4. Next, which one of the following compound is acidic? It is simply acetylene, that is answer 4th. C2H2 is acetylene. Next, dilute permanganate oxidizes acetylene to oxalic acid. 3, answer 3. Next, which one of the following method is not suitable for the preparation of alkynes? As I said, dehalogenation, dehydrohalogenation, decarboxylation are suitable, but dehydration. In the case of alkynes, dehydration is not possible. Next, calcium carbide gives calcium oxide. X is calcium oxide, and that is coal with the calcium carbide, calcium carbide, acetylene. So the answer goes to the calcium oxide and the calcium carbide. That is combination 3. Next. Acetylene sodamide gives a sodium salt. These sodium salts react with alkynes. Sodium salts react with Rx. And the X and sodium will go out, R containing alkynes. So this is a method of extension of the alkynes. So here the extended group is isopropyl group. So isopropyl containing halogen should be there. Is it chlorine or bromine? Means we have a sodium bromide is the right side product. Therefore, 2-bromopropane is the right answer. Next. What is the catalyst used in the reaction? The hydration catalyst it is. It is a constant sulfuric acid as well as mercuric sulfate. So the answer goes to the 4, that is both 2 and 3. Next. Reductive ozonolysis converts acetylene into glyoxal. That is triple bond is cut into the double bond is cut, one single bond restores. Both will become aldehyde because it is reductive ozonolysis or normal ozonolysis leads to give the glyoxal. Next. Acetylene is converted into benzene by using trimerization come cyclization. The reagent is a red hot copper tubes. Next, 4th answer. The molecule that shows acidic property, acetylene, that is answer 3.